Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. So you say your MacBook is losing battery power while it sleeps at night. Well, let's see if we can fix it. MacMost is brought to you thanks to its community of supporters. Join us and get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. So online forums are filled with people complaining that while they put their MacBook, MacBook Pro, or MacBook Air to sleep at night, it wakes up in the morning and it's lost a considerable amount of its battery power. I'm not talking about 3 or 4%. That's kind of normal. It's doing some maintenance at night. It's checking your email and all of that. So it's okay to lose a little bit. But losing 20, 30, 50% is not normal. And it means that most likely some piece of software is waking it up and using some of that battery while you think it's sleeping.
So what we're going to do is we're going to compile a list of suspects. Apps and system extensions that may be preventing your Mac from sleeping and draining your battery at night. The first place we're going to look is Activity Monitor. The easiest way to get there is Command Space to bring up Spotlight, search for Activity Monitor, hit Return to launch it. Now you're not going to see anything here right away that will help you. What we're going to do is go to View Columns, and there's a column here we can turn on called Preventing Sleep. And this will actually list apps that are stopping your Mac from sleeping. We're going to sort by that column. I'm going to click it as many times as I need to get all the yeses at the top. Now these, they're the beginning of our list of suspects. You'll see things in here that are apps that you know, system extensions that you've installed, and things that you may not know. Like for instance, HIDD. HIDD is the Human Interface Device Daemon, and it's just the part of your Mac that talks to your trackpad or mouse and keyboard. So nothing unusual there. But we'll take a note of what apps show up with yeses next to them. Next, we're going to go to System Preferences, and then go to Users and Groups and click on Login Items at the top. And we're going to see a list of apps and extensions that will launch automatically. So you may not even know that they're running because they just launch when you log in. Now a lot of times people see things here and say, oh, let me try to turn that off. And they'll go right to this checkbox here. This checkbox is for whether or not the app is hidden when it's launched. It doesn't actually stop it from launching. So ignore this. If you wanted to remove something from here, you could click it and hit the minus button. But that's not the proper way to do it because there could be an app or something you're using that's relying on this and now you're going to get errors and all that, or it's going to automatically be added back to the list. The proper way to remove it is to figure out what the app is and find out how to remove it from the list. For instance, Night Owl here is this little extension here that allows me to easily switch between light and dark mode. If I go to settings in it, I can see there's a run on boot setting. I turn that off and it removes from the list. That's the proper way to remove it. You could also control click on anything in here and show in Finder. So if there's something listed here and you don't recognize it, you don't know what it is, then show in Finder will bring it up. Sometimes the location will make it obvious what app that process belongs to. In addition to turning these off, sometimes you just want to uninstall them. If it's something you're really not using anymore, you want to find the app, find the proper way to uninstall it using the app's uninstaller or removing it using Launchpad.
So we're going to continue to look for suspects, this time using the terminal. Now don't worry if you're not comfortable using the terminal. We're not actually going to use it to change anything. We're just going to examine some settings and some log files.
So to launch the terminal, use Command Space, search for terminal, and launch it. Now the command we're going to run is called pm set -g assertions. And this is going to give us a list of things that are telling your Mac that it shouldn't go to sleep. Now, your Mac isn't sleeping right now, so there's going to be a bunch of stuff there. And the thing that's keeping your Mac awake at night may not be there because this isn't the middle of the night. So we're just going to get some more suspects out of here. We may not find the culprit. So you're going to see a bunch of things up here with ones next to them, and they'll all kind of make sense. For instance, you're using your Mac now, so of course that's not going to go to sleep. I even have an external drive that's in use right now. It's going to prevent your Mac from going to sleep. Then you're going to get a list of things, and some of these you'll recognize because they'll have names of apps, like ScreenFlow is what I'm using to record this right now. We're just looking for suspects now. We don't need to understand every single line here. What you do want to look for are apps that you see. Like for instance, if you see Google Chrome here. Google Chrome has been known to keep Macs awake at night if you're viewing certain web pages, like certain parts of YouTube. So if you see a bunch of Google Chrome stuff here, then maybe Google Chrome might be a suspect for this. Now next I'm going to clear this using Command K and clear it. Here's the next one. It's also PM set and then this time log, and I'm going to use grep to basically filter out the lines and only get lines that have the word sleep or wake in them surrounded by spaces and only give me the last 50 of those. I'll include these commands here in the post at MacMost.com. Okay, so this is actually a log of things. This isn't telling me what's happening now, but what's happened in the past. So I can see here that in fact Google Chrome has kept my Mac awake. So definitely a suspect. Now let's do one last command. This is actually going to be log show for the last 4 hours. We can change that to 8 hours, for instance. And then it's going to put it in the style of a system log, and it's going to look also for wake and sleep. And this one will take a little bit longer to run. So note any apps or things that you recognize in here as well.
So now that you have a list of suspects, you can simply test it out. The next time you put your MacBook to sleep for the night, make sure those things are no longer running. Make sure they've been quit, maybe quit out of those system extensions, and see if your MacBook sleeps without draining the battery too much. If it does, you know it's one of those things. Maybe you can add them in one by one to see which one is actually causing the issue. And you may or may not have your problem solved. If you don't, here are the next steps.
So Apple actually has a page that pertains to this. I'll include the link on the website. Part of this page talks about if your Mac wakes when it should be sleeping or it doesn't go to sleep at all. And it has some suggestions here. One of the suggestions is to go into System Preferences and then look under Energy Saver. And you should look at Wake for Network Access and try turning that off. That's another suspect as well. There's also some suggestions here. One of those is to reset the SMC and reset the NVRAM. And there are steps here. I've also done videos on those in the past. So you can try those out, then let it sleep at night and see if resetting those have fixed the problem. Apple then suggests trying some more tests. One such test is to start up in safe mode. That's when you restart your Mac holding the shift key down. And that puts it into safe mode. Safe mode doesn't run any extras, any extensions, anything that's supposed to launch at startup. Basically, it's launching your Mac bare bones. So what you want to do is just before you go to sleep, restart your Mac in safe mode and then let it sleep the night on safe mode. If it works and your battery doesn't drain, that means there definitely is some piece of software running on your Mac, some system extension or something that is draining the battery, because that didn't launch during safe mode and everything was fine.
Now, similar to safe mode, you can always create a new user account. You can create as many user accounts on your Mac as you want. Don't do anything special with a user account. Don't set anything, don't run any apps, nothing. So then log out of all your user accounts and log into that new user account just before you put your Mac to sleep at night. If the battery doesn't drain with that, you know it's a difference between a brand new user account and what you've got going on that is causing the issue. So if none of this has led to a solution, don't worry too much about it. After all, we're not all computer experts. We're not all auto mechanics either. That's why we go and we take our cars to shops to get them fixed, right? So you know you can take it to the Genius Bar or a local tech expert, have them look at it, and you have a lot of information that you can give them. In the meantime, there is a temporary fix, and that is to simply not let your MacBook sit just on battery power at night. Have it plugged in. I have to mention that because there's still a few people out there that for some reason believe that they shouldn't keep their MacBooks plugged in at night. You absolutely should. You should keep it plugged in whenever you can. Now sometimes it's not possible. Like for instance, you have one charger, it sits on your desk, so if your MacBook ends up on your nightstand at night, it's not easy to plug it in. But if you're having this issue and you can't take it to an expert right away, then you may just have to keep it plugged in at night to avoid the battery draining. So if there's one takeaway from this, it's that it's not normal to have your MacBook battery drain a lot at night. If that's happening to you, you should try to figure out what it is or take it to an expert for help.